And I have to tell you, as I understand it, they're being sued by a bunch of landowners who are saying, you're using the facilities to run this fiber network on the same facilities that you're running your power network on, but our contract and our lease doesn't state that you can run fiber on that, only power. And so what they're doing is they're triple dipping. I mean, they're running the network on the same equipment that they, or the same facilities and the same right of ways that which they were given by government fiat, I might add, for the broadband side. And then when they get it here, there's a spot in West Plains where it terminates here. But you know what? They will charge you to get it from St. Louis or Kansas City or Memphis or wherever you buy it to get to this point. I can buy it for 50 cents up there, but it cost me $100 to get it delivered here. That's incomprehensible.
Well, that's what, you know, monopolies do. Monopolies control access, they get special privileges, and then they just rob the consumers. When I was a kid, I'm so old enough to remember when long distance was the town 5 miles away.
Right.
And cost a ton of money.
Sure.
And so you didn't call the town 5 miles away.
You wrote a letter.
Yeah. But the town 5 miles away to the north wasn't long distance. You could call people there, but you didn't. The other people, you just forgot about them.
Exactly.
Couldn't afford to call them. Once we broke up the monopoly, now you got free long distance.
Sure.
Why? The free market.
Exactly. Competition.
Mm-hmm.
I went to a bunch of these broadband meetings. I'm here to tell you, these things ran like little socialist party meetings. What, you know what? I used the word competition, and you know what they told me? Don't use the word competition. We think that's too aggressive. You need to use the word choice. I swear to God, that is the absolute truth. And you're hearing it from the horse's mouth. They told me that the word competition is not one that the government approves of because it is too aggressive and too argumentative. You should use the word choice.
Oh, I tell you, you're now on a subject that just infuriates me, the control of language. Lenin said, he who controls the language controls reality.
Absolutely.
The minute you let the left start telling you what you can say on any subject, you've already lost.
And you'll notice that nothing is actually what it's called, what it is. You know,
okay,
everything, it's all obfuscation. You know how I analogize this? It's like every time the government opens its mouth to talk, it's like popping a smoke grenade and setting it down in the middle of the room. And suddenly the room is filled with smoke and you can't see anything anymore. And it's all obfuscation and trickery used by in language. And, you know, they pass all these crazy laws and then they have the unmitigated gall to sit down there and say, well, we didn't realize the language that we used. You know what? I don't buy it. You guys are legal-minded think tanks, and you very, very carefully chose that language to leave it wide open for your own personal interpretation or to make it, you know, something that was abusive of the freedoms and the liberties of the American public, like this NDAA thing. By the way, if you become governor, I'm here to tell you, if you don't support this issue, I won't support you. And that is that we need a constitutional amendment that will ban any state employee, whether it be public, whether it be public safety under law enforcement, whether it be the National Guard, whether it be emergency services, whether it be the clerk who sits there and handles mail. No state of Missouri employee should be, and it should be a criminal penalization called treason, for acting with the federal government under this NDAA or supporting it or enhancing it or working with them in any way, shape, or form. That is the most treasonous and unconstitutional document that has been passed in the United States ever. Ever. You cannot restrict habeas corpus rights from American citizens. And I'll tell you something. They just had an opportunity to retract that language out of there. And Joanne Emerson, who happens to be our local representative in the House, voted against pulling that language out. And she voted for the NDAA in the first place. She's on my hit list. I'm very, very unhappy. This NDAA thing is treason. And it is absolutely one of the first steps to a fascist government. And I'm here to tell you, on a personal level, if that's not something that you will stand behind, one, you can't get that repealed because it's a federal issue, but you can take action. 7 states have already passed a constitutional amendment to bar it, and 18 current other states are looking at it, including Missouri. And I have to tell you, the federal government says to us, oh, that's really not what it means. That's a lie. Because if seven states have already taken the language and passed a constitutional amendment to block it, and 18 others are looking at it, we're not all wrong. You're only paranoid when you're the only one who's nervous. When everybody in the room is nervous, it's not paranoid anymore. It's called self-survival or situational awareness.
Yeah, I mean, look, I agree that language is extraordinarily dangerous, and I would support a constitutional amendment barring it here in Missouri.
Thank you.
You can't. The only thing you said, I can't do just a constitutional matter. We can't charge someone with treason at the state level. The Constitution prohibits that.
That's I get it.
Federal. But, yes, I agree with you. In what happens in bad times or scary times, governments use our fright to take away our liberties. One idiot tries to detonate a shoe bomb, and millions of people take off their shoes thereafter for years.
Right.
One person now, I guess, tries to stuff a bomb in their underwear. Now we're getting pat-downs and see-through searches.
Pat-downs? Did you hear that the TSA is now reaching inside your underwear with their hands, palm side, not the back of their hand? They now reach in and run their hand all the way around your waistband.
Well, now Al-Qaeda is trying to work on inserting bombs inside people through surgery. So now will they be able to open us up?
Yeah.
Where does this end? You know, this
it's all scare tactic anyway. You know, James Madison said that crisis is the rallying cry of the tyrant.
Absolutely.
And boy, if we don't hear the word crisis every other day from our government. And now this new federal policy that they've got out here, they're trying to pass this. And I don't know if you're aware of this or not. This was announced the other day. They're trying to pass the ability in Congress for the U.S. to start using propaganda against the American people. Did you hear about that one?
I did.
I'll send it to you in email if you haven't.
No,
I'm smoking mad. Because they say that they can't get their message out any other way.
Well, they're doing it now. They're not calling it propaganda.
I realize that. But, man, all of a sudden, once it becomes legal for them to use disinformation in a blatant way, you know, social media will be blanketed with it. We'll have Obama standing there on every forward poster with a fist raised in the air doing the fascist argument that we've ever seen.
One of the things I used to mock my colleagues about at Harvard, because I was there as they were just implementing the first of the campus speech codes, what you could say, because heaven forbid there should be freedom of speech on university campuses.
Yeah, the bastion of the legal learning
uh-huh.
center,
and,
right?
Yeah, and they were introducing it. We were debating it then. Andy Gott implemented, and they've been there ever since, and it was one of the leads for all of the campus speech codes. And I said to them, you know, the left doesn't believe in free speech. You talk about free speech when you're out of power, and then immediately when you're in power, you want to shut everybody up and you want to engage in disinformation.
Exactly. It's only free speech as long as I'm doing it.
Yeah, you were talking about the smoke grenade earlier.
Yeah.
I say to people a little, something slightly different. I say, when the left gives you a word, assume the word means the opposite. You're always in opposite land.
There you go.
So, you know, the Patient Affordable Care and Choice Act
yeah.
means we will raise cost and take away your choice. As
there
long
you go.
As you understand that. I mean, even the names of leftist dictatorships like North Korea, the People's Democratic Republic of North Korea.
Right.
It's actually none of those things.
Right.
It's all opposite land.
We got to take a break, Bill. We'll be right back. When we come back, I'd like you to just touch on public sector unions and school choice and or any other issue that you want, you know, that you want to address, because I don't want to, you know, create your platform for you. I just really, those were issues that were driving me crazy. So we're going to take a break, folks. When we come back, we're going to have Bill Randles again for the last 15 minutes of the show. His website is BillRandles.com, and the last name is spelled RANDLES. So get over there, educate yourself. If you support this guy, and he sure sounds like he's got the right story to me, then educate yourself, learn what his platform is, and then jump in there and support him. Lick stamps, stuff envelopes, make calls on his behalf, donate money if you can afford it. Do what you got to do. Show up at his events and clap and cheer. I don't care what you do, but do something. We'll be right back.